Good morning. So in our previous video, we understood the structural and functional unit of a nervous system, which is nothing but a neuron. So we saw how a neuron looks like, the different parts of a neuron, what is the role of each and every part of a neuron, we understood. So let us move on to the next concept of nervous system, which is something about stimulus. We learned today a few different concepts on the stimulus. It is a very small session, but an interesting session. So I've written here something. A stimulus, it is an observable or detectable change in the external or internal environment to which an organism reacts. In simple terms, if I have to tell you is, what is stimulus? How do we react to it? Like how our senses react to it, right? When something involuntary or something external or internal environment, when there is some sensation going on, how do our brain reacts to it? In simple words, how do we react to it? So this is the definition of a stimulus. Now, I'll give you some instances. Say for about example, the first one, when you touch a hot pan. Okay. The second instance I'll give you, you step on a thorns. Step on thorns. Okay. So, okay, enough. These two instances are enough. So what we do actually, so suddenly if I touch a hot pan, what do? Of course, we immediately withdraw our hands. So what do we do when we step on thorns? We just jump out. We immediately give a reaction to it, right? So in both the cases, what is happening? We are immediately giving a reaction and then we are thinking. Right? You touched a hot pan. Did you think, oh, this was a hot pan, this was a tea pan, or anything? Did you think anything? No. There is thinking is not involved in that. What is involved? Reactions are involved. Now, what was the reaction here? Withdrawing your hand was a reaction. Jumping out of that was a reaction, right? Then we thought, what was it? So here, what is coming? Reaction is coming first. So in best terms, what I can tell here is this a stimulus? Yes, this is a stimulus, external stimulus, what I can say. What was the stimulus in the first case? So when I'm touching a hot pan, I'm sensing some hot stimulus here. That means my body, my fingers are sensing certain temperature, right? What was the stimulus here? We are feeling the stimulus of pricking. Our body or our legs or our foot is sensing the stimulus of pricking. So that is a sensation what we are getting. External sensation or external stimulus. So here, the stimulus on which or the involuntary stimulus on which we react, that is known as a reflex action. So I just define once again, an involuntary stimulus. What do you mean involuntary? Right? Do I, for example, I will think, okay, now I'm going to touch a hot pan, but I will not react this way. I will react in some other way. Can we assume that? Can we pre-assume that we will react in this way only? No, it will not happen. It comes out automatically, right, from our body. So, that is nothing but involuntary response to the stimulus. It is known as reflex arc. I just dropped this part. So, if we will understand this, I will just write it on the board here. And involuntary response to the stimulus is called what? Reflex action. How is this reflex action, or how is this involuntary response of what we call reflex action, is different from other involuntary activities which is happening in our body? So there are so many involuntary activities. Life processes chapter itself was a whole involuntary activities, right? Breathing, respiration, digestion, circulation, right? Do we react to it? Okay, do we do? Okay, now I'm having my food. Now my body is digesting it. Digestion process is going on. Do we react for that? No, that happens. Automatically that happens in our body. My heart is circulating, pumping blood and all, right? Do we react for that? No. Those processes will happen on itself. But here are the certain involuntary processes to which we respond. Unknowingly we respond, right? That is called as reflex action. So reflex action has no definite plan. It happens automatically. Now when reflex action is taking place, which part? Now as we always tell that, when I in neuron we studied that, yes, we see something, we touch something, suddenly the neurons start moving. Neuron, then to our brain, again from our brain, it sends a signal, neuron, then to the neuromuscular junction. We understood that, right? Will the same thing happen here? Let us just check out. Let us assume that now I'm touching something hot. So suddenly what will happen? I have touched it. So neuron will go sending signals. Now, till it reaches my brain, it will send the signal. Do you think it will be a quick response? Let us understand that by a small figure to make you understand how actually the reflex action will take place. Okay, I just tried to draw a simple figure so that I can make you understand how actually it happens. Now basically we know that. So this is my arm. When I touch something hot, I immediately withdraw. What actually is happening in this process? So this is a fire over here. Now what happens? We touch a hot object. So when we touch a hot object, again the signal has to go here. Under this reflex action, usually there are many neurons involved in our body, correct? For each and everything. But in reflex action, depends on what type of situation it is, we have basically only 3 neurons involved. Right? In this particular scenario. Now suppose if I tell you this another scenario which we had discussed, wherein I was stepping on a thorn, there only 2 neurons are responsible. So let's go with this, which is more simple and to understand here. There are 3 neurons involved here. Which are the 3 neurons? Let us see and how it actually takes. So the minute I touch a hot object, electric impulses starts moving. Can you see this arrow mark which I have drawn? Yes. This is something our muscle, right? Our muscles over here. So from muscles, again it travels and reaches where? This is not a brain. It reaches our spinal cord. Usually what will happen, as we know that there are nerves coming out of from our brain and there are nerves also coming from our spinal cord throughout our body. So any messages go has to go via that. So here also what will happen in this scenario, the electric impulses start traveling through this hole is one neuron, right? We had already discussed it is the longest part, or we can say is it is the longest cell in our body, neuron. So this whole is one neuron. It reaches the spinal cord. What is the role of spinal cord? Any information what spinal cord will get, it has to send to the brain. Spinal cord will also do that. The information is sent to the brain. But when it is sent to the brain has to again take the information, understand and send back. But there what will happen? That consumes lots of time. So what it will do? It has sent to the brain, but it will not wait for the brain to respond. Right? The information is gone to the brain that I have touched something hot. But the spinal cord, what information is sent? Spinal cord will not wait for the brain's order. Spinal cord will take its own decision. What the spinal cord will do? It will send a message to a relay neuron informing. From relay neuron, again it reaches our muscle. Right? From muscle, it sends to a motor neuron. What is motor neuron? So motor neuron will tell me, withdraw my hand immediately. So how many neurons are involved? Sensory neuron, relay neuron and motor neuron. Who took the decision? Spinal cord took the decision. Brain was not involved in this, but still we did our duty. We sent the information to the brain, but we did not take the permission from the brain what to do. Things were decided by spinal cord. So this is the action. So now what has happened here? We have chosen a shortcut path, right? We had to go all along the brain, ask permission, then come and give the reply. But we did not choose that. we thought of informing, but we chose a shortcut path here. What shortcut path? We chose a shortcut path of surpassing the brain and only going via spinal cord. So the action in which, or the reflex action in which the brain is not involved and it goes through a spinal cord, and then we get the involuntary response here. Such an action is called as a reflex arc. Why it is called an arc? Why? Because we are not completing it. We are just coming this way by surpassing the brain. So we define that as a pathway through which the nerve impulses travel. This is the pathway. The pathway through which the nerve impulses travel through the spinal cord is known as reflex arc. Usually the figure is not asked. Sometimes what they do in your examination is they give you the figure and they ask you to label, in the most of the cases, right? Let us understand this reflex arc in a small flowchart. So this is the pathway through which the nerve impulses travel during reflex action. This is the heat stimulus. So it reaches our receptor, that is nothing but skin. Skin, which neuron is present? Sensory neuron, which can sense. From sensory neuron, the one longest neuron, which is goes to the spinal cord. From spinal cord, it goes to relay neuron to convey. From relay neuron to the effector organ. Where should this relay neuron go and tell? It should tell the effector organ, which organ it is affected, which is nothing but muscle. So muscle, which neuron will act here? Motor neuron. Motor is all for the activities. From motor neuron to response. What is the response? Hand withdrawal. This flowchart is very important whenever a question is asked on reflex arc, right? You can fetch full marks if this is written. A very important flowchart. So is this very clear? So the pathway through which the nerve impulses travel during reflex action is called reflex arc. One important thing what I would like to stress more on here is, as we told, spinal cord will take a decision here. But when the stimulus was there, spinal cord was first job. What did the spinal cord do? Spinal cord also gave the information to brain, right? But it did not wait for the feedback of the brain. But now your brain knows. What does it know? That you have touched a hot object. So brain will come to know everything, right? Something has happened and it knows. It has already made a picture, or it is already registered in your brain that something has happened. Even though the brain has not given any decision, it's already registered in the brain. Now what happens here in this scenario? For example, let us take an example. If you have kids at home, your mom tells, please don't touch that, it is very hot. That kid is not aware what is hot, what is cold, it's not aware of anything. So the kid accidentally or knowingly, unknowingly will go and touch the hot object. Heat stimulus. So suddenly the heat stimulus, sensory neuron, spinal cord, relay neuron, motor neuron, the kid will immediately withdraw hand, right? Because the kid did not know what was hot, what was cold, but still the response came, immediate response came, reflex action happened there. Now again the second time the kid will go there, mom will tell, do not touch, it is very hot. Do you think the kid will go and touch it again purposely knowing that it is hot? No, it will not go, because the information is registered in the kid's brain, that is, it is hot. Last time what happened? When I touched that, I felt the sensation, so I had to withdraw my hand. I slightly burnt my hand. Correct? So those things are registered in our brain. But unknowingly, if you go and touch, yes, there we can't do anything. But we know certain things. Why? Because in all the actions, all the information is first is also going to the brain. Let that be a reflex action or let that be any other things what we do, our brain knows, things are registered there. Only thing is, the decision was passed, it was taken by spinal cord, we gave our response immediately. But next time, knowingly we will not do the things because we know what is it, right? So this is reflex action. So there are basically three types of responses when we talk about this. One is voluntary response, one is involuntary response, and another is reflex response. Now reflex response, we have already studied where in reflex response only our spinal cord is involved. When we talk about voluntary response and involuntary response, our brain is involved. About which part of our brain is involved, we do that in the next session. Yeah, another most important thing is, what is the need of reflex arc, right? Now, anyways, why spinal cord had to take a decision? It's okay, brain could have taken unnecessary, everything decision is taken by brain. Then why only here spinal cord had to take a decision? What was the need for that reflex arc actually? There was a need because when the things are happening, when the stimulus or when the electric signals will go to the brain, it will take some time for the brain to think and give the command, right? By meanwhile, what would happen? You would be touching like this. Okay, my brain is giving me a response. Wait, let me think. Till then, you will burn your hands, right? That is why in reflex action, we don't wait for our brain so that certain injuries can happen. That is why we give a sudden quick response. That is why only the reflex responses are given by spinal cord. All responses, that is voluntary response, involuntary response. Again, different parts of brains are involved. We will be doing that in our next session. So, this is all about today's class. The most interesting session, what I feel, reflex arc and reflex action. Any doubt in today's class, you can call on the same day of the video set. And in our next session, we will be studying about the most complicated yet the beautiful part of our human body, that is human brain. Thank you.